Andy, your thoughts about this game?
Yeah, first of all, sorry, I'm the one here, not Coach Tab. Coach Tab has been sick for the past week. He tried earlier, but he didn't go in. So hopefully, we'll get him back in time for practice or for the next game. This was a tough game for us. Of course, NU's a very tough team. We stood toe-to-toe against them. I think Reinhard, Humamoy really stepped up for NU, really played a very good game. Shot the lights out just showed the UAP who he is. Down the stretch, couple of plays for us that we could have, if possible, we could have done better, could have executed better for us. Defensively, especially in the fourth, we were happy with the way we defended. Credit to them and credit to NU's defense, okay? They made things tough for us to execute. So that's what we're going to be looking at, how to improve our execution also for our next game.
Okay, the players want other questions.
Coach?
Coach, last game you talked about decision making in the end. Coach Tab talked about decision making in the end game. And parang, like today, as you said, there were some plays that you could have done better. Moving forward, how do you plan on, I guess, addressing that certain part? Because it's not about parang X's and O's, no? Parang it's about yung, ano po yung iniisip ng players here at the end game.
Yeah. As the process is for us, you know, we're gonna watch tape. We're gonna go over, especially last few possessions with our players, hoping that we can point to them what they could have done better. And you're correct with decision making. I think that's very important for us, especially with the situation that we're in. You know. The game in itself, there was pressure, and our position right now, there's a lot of pressure too. So, we have to embrace the pressure and meet it head on and not back away from it, because now going forward, there will be a lot of pressure on us. So, how we approach this is very important.
Coach, kamusta lang yung moral ng team after 3 straight losses? Anong sinasabi niyo sa kanila dun sa?
Well, mga pala at least dito, kasi we were focused on this game, actually. I guess, kaya pala, mga pala at least dito, we really just focused on this game. We wanted to look at the things that we did wrong so we can improve and be better headed into the next few games. That's our attitude. So the, you know, collective mentality, we're hoping that it continues to your mentality of the team would still be there, and us really coming together, especially down the stretch, hopefully that in the next few games we'll be able to put things together, whole game.
Coach, do you think how would it affect the demeanor of the players knowing that it's 3 straight losses for Ateneo?
I guess it's certainly tough, but one thing, of course, we said in the dugout, it's normal not to feel good though about the loss, so we have to feel that, of course. And but also, I guess the approach for us is we cannot dwell and think about this loss because we have games to play and we have games to win. That should be our mentality going forward. So we cannot feel sorry for ourselves because the season isn't over yet. We still have games that have to be played and have to be won. So that's the message in the dugout. So we want them to come together all the more. Diba? Parang win together doesn't mean if you lose, kanya kanya. So win together, lose together, we want them to still be unified as a team headed towards our next game.
Coach Doc?
Coach, can you talk about Gab Gomez? How come he's had limited
Militant output so far this season when he was a key contributor last season towards the tail end of last season.
Towards the tail end, yeah. It's a bit hard and it's not an easy question to answer. A lot of factors heading in. Some also timing with some injuries or some practice. Also with, I think, Ian Espinosa has emerged to be a very good defensive player for us. And we're a very good partner back for us the point position. And Jared Brown also has hit shots for us. So it's a bit hard. Na parang who's playing well between the three of them will play. It's not that we don't want Gap to play. You know, we want him to play well. We need him to play well for us. But we've got to make sure that we put in the guys also that have been performing for us.
But you talked about being focused on the present. But how about, I guess, background noise? Because people are saying that this is the first three straight losses of Ateneo since 2013, or people are speculating about the team right now. So I guess, parang, is there parang active efforts in order to kind of like shut that out? For not just for the players, but also for the whole community and how you're going to play your next few games?
Yeah, I didn't know that matagal na pala yung three state losses.
Season 76.
Okay, so thank you for making me aware. It's the background noise. That's the point. I guess, you know, it's still there. It's people will be talking, but we cannot lose sight of our goal and our objectives. That's why we have to be more laser focused in our concentration and in our mindset. That's why I'm saying parang, it has to be collective, yung team thinking namin. So we cannot be distracted or even bothered by those thoughts because certainly that won't help us. It's there, of course, like you mentioned, but we're focusing team. That's been a big emphasis for us, that we have to think team. We have to think team, what's inside our circle. That's the most important thing.
Coach, from a coaching standpoint for you, Coach Tab, the rest of the staff, like how do you handle being in a relatively rare position of losing like this amount of games with such a young crew? Like how do you keep like yourselves, or what's the mindset on how to handle your players who are young and also new to this kind of like level and pressure as well?
Yeah, I think the mindset is not also dwelling on the negatives because or the outside noise or thinking about we're in a situation where we lost a lot of games. It has to come from each one of us, coaching staff, leaders of the team, the players. It has to come from us. And season's not yet over. That's what we've been saying. So we're going to prepare hard, we're going to watch tape, and we're going to prepare for the next game. We've got a job to do, even though, Coach Tab's not here, because he's won a lot, but he's lost a lot also in his career. That's basketball. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Sometimes you win a lot, sometimes you lose a lot. But what's important is the mindset that we have. And like I said, it has to come from us then. So in determination namin, I think it's very important.
Thank you, Coach Sandy.